Hi, welcome back to Wesbury 101. I'm Brian Wesbury, Chief Economist at First Trust Portfolios. Remember, we want to be the antidote to conventional wisdom. Well, first of all, it's coming up on Thanksgiving. We celebrate the plenty of a market system, and we have a lot to celebrate. We're reopening the economy. The stock market is hitting all-time highs. It's an amazing period of history. However, having said that, we have done unprecedented things in the past 20 months, 21 months, locking down the economy, the Federal Reserve printing $4 trillion new dollars, the government borrowing over $5 trillion from our kids and grandkids to hand out so that people can spend it today. And when you look at these unprecedented things, I hear it all the time when I am on the road. People are scared that government has grown so much, that the printing press from the Federal Reserve has been running so hot, and they're also worried about locking down the economy again. And so the question becomes, how do we analyze the economy, investing, the markets, when unprecedented things are happening? Obviously, it's hard to look back in history if it's unprecedented, if it's never happened before. And so one of the ways that I'm dealing with this, and I think you ought to deal with it this way as well, is to divide the world up, divide our future up into two periods of time. Let's call it the next 12 months. By now, we can sort of think of that as 2022. And then after that. And so one of the things that people are worried about is all this government spending, all of this money printing having an impact on inflation. And we ought to get used to that because it is here. But at the same time, that money printing, this borrowing and spending that we are experiencing right now, whether I like it as an economist or not, it's like giving morphine to an accident victim. You're damaged. We locked down the economy. You're damaged. We had a pandemic. However, the morphine makes it almost impossible to feel that pain. And that's where we are right now. It's a flood of money lifting jobs, lifting economic growth, lifting profits, holding down interest rates. And as a result, the stock market is still undervalued. And my belief is that as this morphine, as this flood rolls through the economy in the next 12 months, could be 10, could be 14, we're going to see more positive developments for the equity markets. At the same time, I also believe people ought to protect themselves against inflation, owning a basket of commodities. Real estate fits into this hard asset category as well, because the value of the dollar is being diminished because we're printing too many dollars. The question is, what happens after that? With all of this spending and all of this money printing, people are being reminded of the 1970s. That's when we had huge growth in government after the Great Society spending programs. Also, the Federal Reserve printed excess money. And when you put those two things together, we ended up with stagflation. And my view is that in the future, we will see slower economic growth. I'm not ready to say it's going to be no economic growth, but slower economic growth because the size of the government has grown. At the same time, we will see this inflationary pressure that we have put in the economy continue into the years ahead. So we will have a whiff of stagflation in the future. The big question is, do investors try to get ready for that now? Do they sell out? Do they run away because of these things that might happen in the future? And I would argue that today, I know in Washington, D.C., they're fighting hard over this new spending bill, and it really is a change in kind of entitlements in America, but it's not passed yet. They're fighting over tax hikes, but they aren't passed yet. So I feel like the best analogy to close today with is this. If we started a baseball game right now and the umpires grabbed us just before we have the first pitch and said, we want you to know that today in the seventh inning, we're going to change the rules. home runs are going to be worth two, or they're going to be worth a half. We're not quite sure yet which one it's going to be. So the question is, how do you play that first six innings? And I would argue you play with the team that you pay. You play with the team that you gave scholarships to. You play normal baseball. And then in the seventh inning, when the rules change, that's when you need to change your strategy. Well, where we are today, we know there's inflation. That's one of the rule changes. So get exposed to some commodities. But we haven't put in new entitlements yet. We haven't put in new and higher tax rates yet. So we're not quite at the seventh inning. So right now, enjoy this first six innings. Stay long. As the economy opens up, we will continue to grow. Profits will continue to rise. And I still think investors don't have to worry about that longer term future yet. Thanks so much for visiting Wesbury 101. We'll see you next time.